When people set out on their PhD, what they really need is to have a confident understanding of exactly where their field of research is up to, so they can make really appropriate strategic choices about what they're going to research, what's most important to research. And they also need the basic research training skills, research methodology, research planning, project management. They need all those things if they're going to complete satisfactorily and happily a 3 or 4 year research project. And this program is explicitly designed in order to provide that kind of support, so that by the time they start their PhDs, they know exactly what they want to do and they know exactly how to do it.
The reason I decided to choose a Master's of Research over Honours is because I felt the Master's of Research at Macquarie University offered more in preparing myself for a possible PhD better as opposed to Honours.
At the end of my undergraduate degree, I considered a few options in terms of other universities and courses around Sydney. Most of them were Honours based, but there are also some Master's based courses. I decided to do the Master's of Research here because it gave me a better opportunity to distill my research interests and spend more time working out what I wanted to do.
What Macquarie decided to do was to follow the model that's most widely practiced around the world, which is to build a 2-year master's program that runs between undergraduate study and PhD and provides students with all that knowledge of advanced disciplinary coursework and that introduction to research training that'll really help them when they start in their PhDs.
So one of the reasons why I got attracted to this course is the way you learn to write. And I have to say, I've done 2 courses so far. One was the research communication that everybody has to do, and the other one was Frontiers in Management and Marketing. Both had so much writing in it, and I enjoyed every minute of it. The end result at the end of the semester, I felt really happy that I actually, the 13 weeks were really spent well, and I've got what I wanted out of that course.
And one of the aims of this program is to make sure that when people go into their PhDs, they're really well equipped to complete that project happily and in a reasonable amount of time. One of the advantages of the program, of course, is that it falls in line with the practice in almost every other country, where a 2-year master's is the standard option that students take who want to go on from undergrad into higher degree research. So our graduates will find it easier if they want to go overseas to pursue their PhD study. They'll find their qualifications much better recognised, and they'll be able to fit in with international practice much more readily.
If you're debating between an Honours or a Master's of Research, I would definitely choose a Master's of Research. It's a lot less stressful because you're not trying to balance coursework and research at the same time, and you also have more time to dedicate to your research. So in an Honours program, you basically only have about 3 months to do a research project, which is far too short, whereas with the Masters you have the full year to concentrate on that research.
I definitely recommend the Masters of Research program. I've had only positive experiences so far, and my academic improvement has been greatly assisted by the staff in the department and the cohort of students that I've gone through with.
I would recommend it. You know, if people are even remotely thinking of learning something different, I would be trying to talk them into go and speak to HDR office, to, you know, get the information, find out what it is that you want to study. But yeah, I would be batting for them to go and give it a shot.